In the course of your lifespan, one thing you may be desperate to avoid is the surgical removal of an organ. Unfortunately, this can't always be prevented. As we age, our organs are increasingly prone to failure, while in other instances, injury and disease can induce irreversible damage. Notably, there are some essential organs, such as the brain, lungs, heart, liver, and kidneys, without which human life cannot be sustained. However, one can live with a single kidney or a single lung. The procedure of removing an organ like the spleen, gallbladder, or a part of the intestine has often sparked curiosity about what happens in the space left behind. You may not be aware, but there are select organs the human body can cope without, including the spleen, the gallbladder, a section of the lung, liver, or intestines, the stomach, colon, reproductive organs, and appendix. Interestingly, it's also common practice during kidney transplants to not remove the malfunctioning kidney, but to instead add a new one. Normally, this new organ is positioned near the bladder, significantly lower than the original kidneys. One key understanding of human anatomy is that our bodies are divided into defined cavities that limit the movement of our organs to some extent. For instance, the heart cannot slide from its position in the pericardial cavity through the thoracic cavity into the abdominal cavity. Nevertheless, the tissues separating these cavities and the space in each cavity possess some degree of flexibility. Generally, each organ remains in its designated area, with only minimal readjustment or shifting when pressure is applied, for example, by a deep inhalation or exhalation. Even so, this is a temporary change, as the body cavities are crowded and the organs must constantly jostle for space. If an organ is surgically removed, other organs will adjust and fill the space that was left. For example, if the gallbladder is removed, the stomach, liver, and pancreas will shift to occupy the space left behind. For more substantial voids, such as when part of the intestine is removed, body fluids fill the space temporarily until connective tissues form to stabilize the remaining organs. The human body is designed to always achieve equilibrium in terms of pressure and comfort of the organs. Think of it as standing in an elevator filled to capacity. If one person gets off, the remaining occupants will naturally shift and fill the space they freed up. Similarly, if a cavity is left in the human body, the surrounding organs will redistribute to fill the void. The advent of organ donation has necessitated different ways to preserve the body's internal environment for ceremonial and viewing purposes, meaning that the volume of the body cavities must remain stable. Thanks to advances in 3D printing, replicas of donated organs can now be created to replace the missing ones. This technique is only used after death occurs. In contrast, the bodies of living donors will naturally redistribute their remaining organs to utilize every bit of available space.